Hi there, Ironbarkers. Welcome to Ironbark Ridge, and we are so excited about welcoming your students back to school. It's been a long, long term. Term three was difficult for all of us. Teachers found it pretty tough teaching online, connecting with your kids online, keeping a classroom environment going in an online environment has been really difficult. We know you guys school. I'm in our interactive playground. We're looking forward to get kids back into this playground, but we are on Darug lands here at Ironbark Ridge, and I acknowledge the custodians of the land, past and present and future. All right, so I'm going to be talking to you about the key dates of the student return as we move into next week and the week after. I'm going to talk to you about all of our safety procedures. We want to set up a safe zone here at school that's inside our school gates, inside the school fence, and we'll tell you a little bit about our operations and how we're going to keep your kids as safe as possible. Remember, it's just about risk minimization, okay? There's always going to be risk in life, but we want to squash that right down to as close to zero as we can get it. I'll talk to you a bit about drop-offs and pickups. I'll talk to you about the structure of our days. I'll talk to you really briefly about Katush and out-of-school hours care, and then I'll tell you where you can go to the department's website for some more information. Okay, lots for you, so bear with me. All right, so next Monday, the 18th of October, we will be having Kinder and Year 1 back in classrooms. The teachers are really excited to get back to the best type of learning that is possible. We know the best place for your kids is in that classroom with their peers, with their teacher, with that learning situation, those routines and resources to help them to grow as a student, both academically but also socially. That working with other kids is so important when it comes to developing into a competent and confident citizen of the world. All right, so we're working with New South Wales Health through the Department of Education. They've given us lots of guidelines about how to set up our school as a safe zone. Now, the first thing that's happened, obviously, is that we are returning to school, and the reason we're doing that is because vaccination rates are so high. Here in the hills, where we are at Ironbark Ridge, the rates are super high. Okay, I mentioned that briefly in the newsletter last week, but this is so important. It keeps us as adults safe. It also keeps our kids safe because we as adults, if we were to pick it up, we have much less capacity to pass on and be infectious. Okay, now our kids can't get vaccinated yet. That's the situation that we are in. So they're coming to school without that protection. But what we want to do is we want to make sure that all of our adults are completely double vaccinated, and that has happened. Okay, all of the staff who will be on site, teachers, non-teaching staff, canteen staff, ground staff, everyone is double vaccinated to keep your kids as safe as possible, but also, quite frankly, to keep adults as safe as possible as well. Okay, so next Monday, 18th of October, kindergarten and year one, they'll be back in classrooms. The following Monday, year two through year six, will be back in their classrooms with their teachers, and all online learning will cease once classroom learning starts. Okay, so we will not be able to provide you with other forms of learning to continue what you've been doing just because you're choosing not to bring your kids back to school. It's safe here. This is the best place for them. You really need to send them back and have some faith and some trust in what we are doing here at school. Now, we're going to adjust the day a little bit. Our 3 to 6s are actually going to start in classrooms at 8:50. So they will arrive at school between 8:30 and 8:50. Okay, so that's the drop-offs in the morning. You'll need to drop all of your kids outside the school. Kindies, ones, right up to year sixes, you will need to drop them outside the school gate or at the gate. They will come in and you will not please. Okay, our kids, even the youngest kindies, they've been here for 6 months. They know how to get their bag to the hanger, to the basketball court. They know where they line up. All of that has not changed. Okay, so they will place their bag in that usual location. 3 to 6s will actually take their bags down to their classroom now because they're going to go in a little bit early. It also allows them to congregate and to sit and wait and chat and enjoy a little bit of a social occasion in that 8:30 to 8:50 time with their friends away from all of the other cohorts, because we're going to keep people, students in their groups a little bit separate from other groups. Okay, so 3 and 4s will go up to their classrooms and put their bag at their classroom, then they'll sit in the area near our container along the high school fence there. There'll be a teacher on duty up there each morning. 5 and 6s will go down past their classrooms, they'll put their bag at their classroom, then they'll come to the grass nearby. Our 1s and 2s will sit in the area on the handball courts and the canteen cola, and our kindies will sit on the basketball court. So they're all 4 separate areas, keeping our students a little bit separate. In the afternoons, our 3 to 6s will finish at 2:50. So at 2:50, they are going to go out the gates, and we need them to clear out the gates. So there's 10 minutes between 2:50 and 3 when our kinders and 1s will start to come up towards the gates. Our year 2s will start to come up. So those younger siblings could be met by the older sibling outside the gate. So you need to have a chat to your 3 to 6er if they're going to be waiting for a little brother or sister. You need to have a chat to your child in K-2 if you are going to be waiting for them outside the gate. You might even come up over the weekend or at some stage and just have a bit of a look and talk to your child about where you'll be waiting. If you're going to be sitting in the car in the big long line, you'll be very patient, obviously, waiting in that line. But you could have that little family name on a card. I'll send out that card so that you can adjust it. So it's got your family name, perhaps even the class as well that your child's in, and pop that up behind the visor or on the passenger dashboard there, so that we can see it as the teachers and we can quickly call out for your child and get them to you and get you away and move that line on as quickly as we can in the afternoon. Okay, so 2:50 for our 3 to 6s and 3 o'clock as usual for our K-2. All right, as I said, we're going to be keeping groups together. So our Ks will stay as a group. Our 1s and 2s will stay together as a group. Our 3s and 4s as a group. And our 5s and 6s as a group. Now, what this means is that in the playground here at school, we have 2 separate areas. And we've been a little bit lucky in that we've got some turf laid down the middle of our oval there to revitalise our oval. And this rain at the moment has been wonderful in settling it in. But it needs a few more weeks just to settle in. And that's allowing us to keep that area with no play. We've got then 2 separate areas of grass, 2 separate hard surface areas with cover, and then 2 separate toilets blocks for our students to use. So our kindies, when they're out there playing, will play away from our 1s and 2s, and their break times will be slightly different to the 3 to 6 students. Okay, so we will be keeping our cohorts of students separate as a safety measure. If there was a case that came into our, we had to isolate some groups, it wouldn't be the whole school, obviously, because we've kept our 4 cohorts fairly separate during the days. Classes, obviously, also will be staying as separate as they can. Okay. Now, we are going to encourage our students to be wearing masks during the day in the classroom. They won't be wearing them outside in the playground. They'll probably leave it on their desk under their pencil case as they go out. They'll wash their hands, they'll get their lunch, and they'll go out and play. They'll come back in, they'll wash their hands again, and then they will go and they'll sit down and they'll pop their mask on within the classroom. Just in that closed environment of the classroom, it's been shown to make quite a difference. I know that if it was my child in there, and my 2 girls will be wearing masks when they're at school as they go back, okay? It's just an extra safety precaution. As I said at the start, it's about getting that risk and just squashing it down to as close to zero as possible. If you don't want your child to wear a mask, that's okay. We might still be encouraging them to do so, and it might be that the 28 other kids in their class have all got masks on and they feel a little bit left out, and that's okay. Give them a mask if that's the case and they really want to wear one, but we won't be mandating masks. That's not our role. That's not what we want to do. We just want to keep our kids as safe as possible, squash that risk, and so we'll be encouraging and we'll be supporting our kids to wear masks. There are some nice tips, child, and we'll be taking our kids through that. So please, if you are encouraging your child to wear a mask, we'll certainly be supporting you in that and encouraging all of our kids. But send them along with a spare one in the bag as well. I can imagine that in a few weeks we're going to have quite a box of lost masks up in lost property. The hope is that won't happen, because hopefully we can keep them all in classrooms, as I said, on desks, in pencil cases or wherever, in bags even. Pop a name on it if you've got a nice material one that we're using. All of our teachers will be wearing masks all the time, even in the playground. So students in the classroom, that's what we're wearing. encouraging to happen. Ventilation and hygiene, obviously, then two other big issues to do with being in classrooms, inside, indoors, where those aerosols can sort of circulate a little bit. So we'll be trying to have all of our windows open, and all our classrooms have great windows, excellent windows. Our school's actually designed in the first place to not need air conditioners. So it does have some really good solar passive sort of design features where the windows can be open, the fans can be on, there's great cross ventilation, and we'll be having air cons on as well to further move that air around so that we can get it out of classrooms and replace it through those open windows and with those fans as well. Hand washing and things like that will be ultra vigorous around that sort of stuff. Yes, we will unfortunately be wasting some time as we go into the classroom, as we come out of the classroom. All the hands will be washed. We'll be wiping down laptops and iPads and desks and those sorts of things as we go throughout the day. The department's actually invested quite a lot of money in extra cleaning in schools. So we have a daytime cleaner now who comes through. A lot of surfaces are wiped down with the disinfectant about halfway through the day, including in the toilets, but also all of those railings and handles and things like that are high touch type of surfaces. They get wiped down with during each day. Now, our activities during the term four time will be slightly adjusted to avoid all of that congregation, those groups crossing over and mixing. So assemblies, celebration days, we'll probably do in a kindy version and then a 1-2 version and a 3-4 version. At this point in time, we won't be able to invite you into those sorts of things, but we'll be able to work out ways of having those in a live format, perhaps streaming it through our YouTube channel or whatever. So you'll be able to watch on and see what's going on and be a part of it as best as possible. Okay, any changes as we go on with that, you know, December time and things like that as it goes forward, we'll just be adjusting our procedures according to the advice from New South Wales Health and from the Department of Education, obviously. Now, Katoosh After School Care will be operating as normal. They will have some procedures that closely mirror our procedures as well. They have their own QR code, so when you do come in to pick up or drop off, you use their QR code. That's different to our school QR code. Okay, now the school QR code is used around meetings. If you are coming into the school for a 10-minute plus sort of an amount of time, then you'll need to sign in with that QR code. There's a special little schools check-in in the New South Wales Service New South Wales app that you can use, and you just scan our QR code and then you log in so that you're a record for that day as being on site. Okay, so that's nice and simple, but if you do have need meeting with us or anything like that, email us, phone us. Sick bay and things like that will be run in a slightly different way so that we can make sure that our kids are safe. We'll be hyper alert around any kids who've got symptoms to do with COVID, obviously any respiratory symptoms, even things like obviously the fever and things like that. We will be hyper alert around that. Our teachers are anxious about it as well. They want to keep their class safe. So if you've got a child who's even, you know, slightly, you know, unwell, please keep them at home until all the symptoms have disappeared and they can come back to school, because runny noses and coughs and splutters and things like that, we will be really quite vigilant around that and giving you a call straight away, and we'll need you to come up and take your child home. And in that case, when you come to the front gate, give us a quick call on the phone. The ladies will tell you to come into the office and they'll have your child ready to go with their bag in the front foyer so that we can, you know, keep everything safe around our school, including our staff. Okay, staff and students, really important to us to keep everyone safe. So on this page here, there's another link down the bottom for further advice for families from the Department of Education. If we do have a case here at school, obviously we'll be communicating very quickly with you. Our procedures are built around both keeping kids safe and also reducing the amount of isolation that may be needed if that's what is required and demanded by New South Wales Health if a case did occur. Now, we've been pretty lucky so far, and I think that's partly due to you guys doing great things at home and being safe with your own lives as well. So keep that up. The vaccination rates in the area around our school keep us safe as well. You know, over 90% fully vaccinated is just a magnificent sort of a place to be. Really reduces that risk coming into our school each day. Okay, so hopefully we've given you a fair bit of information there. Hopefully not too much, but we're really looking forward to seeing your kids back here at school, back into our interactive playground, back into our oval that's got new grass on it, and looking forward to these things relaxing as we move towards the Christmas time. Let's just get ourselves to the end of the year. We've got teachers ready to assess, teachers ready to get kids in, to work out where their learning's up to give them those next little steps and challenges and things like that. like that to keep that growth going, to make sure that we can get our kids to the end of the year in as best shape as possible. So we look forward to seeing KN1 next Monday, 18th, 2 to 6 on the 25th of October. Our teachers are just super excited to have themselves back in the school, but also their class back in that classroom and things back to normal as much as possible. So thanks, guys. See you later, Ironbuckers. We will talk to you soon.